Hello friends, in this video we'll be talking about the plant tissue culture. This is the module 3, and in this video particularly we are going to talk about the root tip culture. That means we need to talk about the culture method from the tissue which is obtained from root, and what is the importance of root tip culture and why at all we do root tip culture. Okay. Now there are several types of cultures that are available, like the culture of intact plants from seed. As we know, this is the default way. Second thing is the embryo culture. That means an isolated embryo can be grown onto the medium and after removal of the seed coat only, and it can be grown very very rapidly. Third one is the organ culture. That means an isolated organ can be grown like the shoot tip or root tip or anther and any kind of region. Now we are going to talk about root tip culture today, which is among the organ culture method. Fourth one is the callus culture. Callus, if a mass of tissue is isolated, which is a undifferentiated cells are growing all the time, like amorphous structure, it is called the callus of plant. And if you take this callus, you can isolate this tissue and allow them to grow in vitro condition, it can give rise to a very very healthy plant. It is called the callus culture. Single cell culture can also be done. The growing individual cell which is obtained from a tissue or callus, we can take the cell and you can put the cell into the medium. That single cell can give rise to a whole new plant. Protoplast culture can also be done. We can produce protoplast from plant cells, removing the cell wall of the plant, and fuse one or two different types of protoplast together to make a hybrid, and then we can utilize the hybrid to cultivate the hybrid onto the plant tissue culture media, and you can get a hybrid plant. So there are three different types of cultures actually. One is a vegetative organ culture, second one is a reproductive organ culture, third one is the embryo culture. The vegetative organ culture means the culture of root, a leaf and shoot, which is the vegetative organs. And we can also culture the reproductive organs like anther, pollen or ovary and ovule of a plant. And the third one is the embryo culture. The most common method is utilizing the vegetative organs because these are easy to access, easy to available, easy to manipulate. Embryo culture is also can be done, but this is quite hard. And reproductive organ culture is the most least commonly used actually. So this is also tough. Okay, this is also hard working culture. Okay. So this is the timeline of how we can do different cultures. Like this is the wild plant we can make through the callus production. So it's the mass of undifferentiated cell. Take this callus can go and produce this genetic stabilizing content of root. Then the shoot will be generated and whole plant will be produced in the bioreactor. We can have the wild plant. From the wild plant we can produce a shoot of the plant and then the root, so we can produce a whole new plants from this wild type of plant cells or the undifferentiated mass of the cells. Root tip culture is discovered by Robbins of USA and Corti of Germany in 1992. It was suggested that the root obtained from the plant, most of the plants are easy to be grown onto this whites medium. So whites medium is vigorously used for the root tip culture. Now what is the importance of root tip culture? Root tip cultures increases our knowledge of carbohydrate metabolism via the plants, and also the role of minerals, ions, vitamins and etc. in the growth of the root of the plant. And the most important thing I'm telling you, the most important thing about this root tip culture is that many times what happens, many alkaloids by the plants which are produced into the root or region of the root. And the plant produces alkaloids in the root. So if we culture root, if we have a root tip culture that it can produce or support the growth of root in higher amounts, we can take out this culture easily from the root, because if something produced in the root, it must be excreted onto the medium where the plant is situated. Now for this root tip culture, if we produce the product into the root, then those alkaloids and whatever it is produced in the root will be excreted onto the culture media, and it is usually very very easy to take up all those ingredients from the culture media than to take from the directly to from the root. Okay, so that's why the root tip culture is important. Okay, now these cultures prove the dependence of roots and on shoots for the hormonal growth. That's another important, because it proves this factor again, that the root development is dependent on the shoot development, because shoot develops first then the root. Now, root culture of leguminous plant help us to study the process of nodule formation and the nitrogen fixation by the bacterium like rhizobium. Okay. And also the root culture can help us in locating the biosynthetic process and biosynthesis of alkaloids by the roots, and we can take up these alkaloids from the roots directly. These are the procedure of root tip culture. That this is a process via the Agrobacterium rhizogenes, because Agrobacterium rhizogenes are typical kind of bacterial species which induce the growth of hairy root, that means a higher amount of root from a single region of plant. Okay. RI plasmid or Agrobacterium rhizogenes plasmid are utilized and it can induce the rhizogenes, and numerous root formation is done. Okay. This hairy root is the result of genetic transformation by Agrobacterium rhizogenes, have attractive properties of secondary metabolite. That's why we utilize this Agrobacterium rhizogenes mediated RI plasmid mediated process for the root development. But because for the normal root tip culture, general root tip culture, we can take up a scrap of cells from the root of the developing from a healthy uninfected plant. That's the most important part. We take this cell and put them onto the culture plates containing all the nutrients for the plant development and growth. Then the plant cell will start to grow and produce the callus, which is the undifferentiated mass of cells. Now this, from the callus, the whole new plant will generate. First the shoot will generate, then the root will generate, and then we put them into the rooting media, which is particularly facilitated the growth of roots, and you can end up with the production of a strong and heavy roots. Okay. Now, advantages of root tip culture. The greatest advantages are of the hairy root is that often exhibit about the same, like that greater biosynthetic capacity of secondary metabolite production can be done utilizing this root tip culture that I have told before. And also the genetic stability is another important part of this root tip culture. Now here are some examples. I can give you four examples in the slide. Like this is the first example from the endangered species of Atropa betica, which displays high accumulation of the major tropane alkaloids, which is called the atropine. Now atropine can be found from this, but it is produced in the root. So if you go with the root tip culture, you can produce a higher amount of atropine, and we can derive atropine from the media. In the second picture, an anticholinergic agent is produced from this plant, and this is called the anticholinergic is produced from this place, and we can utilize them. Okay, this anticholinergic agent is substance that blocks the neurotransmitter acetylcholine in the central and peripheral nervous system. That can be obtained from this plant, and you can obtain this via the root tip culture. Catharanthus roseus. Catharanthus roseus is a type of plant which we can in case of this plant, we can go through this hairy root production, because in this hairy root production, it can produce the alkaloids, and it can lead to the accumulation of higher levels of alkaloids. Alkaloids like vincristine, which is the brand name is Oncovin, and formerly known as leurocristine. Okay, so vincristine or leurocristine, which is also known as VCR, can be produced from this Catharanthus roseus, and which is a very, very important ingredient of the high blood pressure and sugar. Lithospermum erythrorhizon is another plant, as you can see here. Now this can also be cultivated using utilizing the Agrobacterium rhizogenes or RI plasmid mediated transfer, development of hairy roots, and it can be grown on the MS medium, but it produces a pigment that cannot be produced when they are cultivated in the MS medium, remember, but when they are cultivated in the liquid medium, it produces the pigment, and you can take the pigment. With this pigment, it has the ability to act against the HIV type 1 infections. Okay. So these are the very, very important examples from this. But this type of plants, as you can see, are getting endangered in nature. They are present in a very few amount in nature. So you must go through the process of micropropagation to develop millions of this type of beneficial plant from one single cells, from root or from shoot. And we can go with this type of root tip culture or shoot tip culture techniques. Now these are the schematic presentations of root tip culture. Now this is the plant. Select the plant material to be cultured, and we have the in vitro culture starting there. Then in second phase, we are having the Agrobacterium rhizogenes in the media, and we instigate this media Agrobacterium rhizogenes to infect this type of plants to develop the plant, the hairy roots. Now, as a result of this infection, hairy roots are developed. Now, these hairy roots, we can take them, we acid this hairy root, and we can found that everything is all right. When you find everything is all right, then the second place what we are doing, we can do this hairy root medium instruction in the solid as well as in the liquid medium. And the hairy root is formed. As you can see, the root is formed in vigorous amounts in this all these cases, and we can utilize. And then we put this hairy root containing cells onto shooting media. As a result, shoot will be developed. Then the whole plant will be developed, and we put them into the bioreactor. When the environment, pH situation, in acidic and pH, light conditions, and everything is controlled in a optimum environmental situation, as a result plant will grow. Then we take up all those necessary ingredients from the plant via the extraction methods. Okay, so that's about the root tip culture, and I hope it will help you. Thank you.